Hello everyone, this is Professor M.S. Koite, Assistant Professor of Department of Agricultural Entomology, KKVA College of Agriculture, Nashik. So in today's lecture, we are going to study the commercial methods of bee rearing under the course number ENTO365, that is Management of Beneficial Insect. So the commercial methods of bee rearing divides into the mainly two types. First one is hive and second one is modern methods of bee rearing. So in hive, which is again divided into two types. First one is indigenous method of beekeeping and second one is movable hive. And the second type, that is modern methods, which is again divided into mainly five types. That is typical movable hive, queen excluder, honey extractor, uncapping knife and last one is other equipment. So these are the different methods of bee rearing. So in today's lecture, we are only study the indigenous method of beekeeping and second one is movable hive. So first method is indigenous method of beekeeping. Rich indigenous knowledge of beekeeping in a variety of hives such as the wall cavities, hollowed logs, scapes, etc. serve to preserve this heritage. These indigenous hives resemble closely the natural nesting sites of the native honeybee, that is Apis serena. So the indigenous method of beekeeping divides into mainly following types. First one is the orchard hives, means these are made up of locally available materials like stones available on the field, clay chop, wheat straw, then circunda grass, then wood for making frames, string and strips of the wood. So this is the orchard hive, which is mainly made up of locally available materials. Then second type is straw hives. These are made usually locally available materials. These are like a rice straw, locally made string for tying straw, then strips of waste wood and wood for making the frames. Then third type is the wall hive. It is a cavity left in the wall when the house is under construction. It is located at a height of about 150 cm from the floor in kitchens as well as storerooms, living rooms and or sheds. The wall hive has an entrance hole of about 2 cm diameter towards the outside. On the inside, it is covered usually with a plant of wood plastered with the mud. So this is the third type, that is the wall hive. Then next one is the log hive. It is a simple structure without any frame and separate chamber. This is prepared by the hollowing out of a piece of a tree trunk, closing both its end and boring a small hole of a suitable size along its length to serve as an entrance. So this is the last type, that is the log hive. So these are the different four types of indigenous methods of beekeeping. First one is the orchard hive, second one is the straw hive, third one is the wall hive and fourth one is the log hive. Then this is the structure of bee hive. So we can see in the image, upper part for the storing the honey and the lower part for brood rearing. Then second type is movable hive. So the scientist Reverend Lorenzo Lorin Langstroth, that is L.L. Langstroth, discovered the movable frame hive. The modern beekeeping became possible after the discovery of movable frame hive in 1851 by Reverend Lorenzo Lorin Langstroth. In India, beekeeping was introduced in 1882 in Bengal. So this is the structure of movable frame hive and which is discovered by the L.L. Langstroth scientist in 1851. So this is the structure of movable frame hive. So first part is stand. So the function of stand is to support the bottom board. So you can see in the image, that is the stand which is used for the support the bottom board. Then second part is bottom board. The use of bottom board is, or it is the floor of the hive having an entrance for the bees. On this board, brood chamber raised. Then third part is brood chamber. The chamber used for rearing of a brood. Frames are placed in this chamber on which bees raise combs. The dimension and the number of frames vary with the type of hive. A wooden dummy board is used to limit the size of brood chamber and is placed at the end of the brood frame. So this is the third part, that is brood chamber for rearing the brood of honeybees. Then third part is frame. Each frame consists of a top bar, two side and a bottom bar. So inner aspect of the top bar has a groove for fixing comb foundation sheet. Sidebar has a four holes for wiring the frame. The frame holds a comb. Then next part is dimension of the hive. In general, for Apis mellifera, that is European honeybee, we use the Langstroth hive name after L.L. Langstroth, and for the Apis serena, use the Bureau of Indian Standard hive A and B type. In 1995, Bureau of Indian Standard introduced the C-type hive based on the Langstroth hive for the Apis mellifera. Well-seasoned wood of kale, tun, teak or rubber can be used for making the good quality beehives. Wood having strong smell is not used. Dimension of different types of beehives being used in India are given below. So first one is super and then top cover. So super dimension may be same as that of brood chamber or half of it depending on the type of bee hive. This is the chamber where bees store surplus honey. Inner cover, a board which acts as a partition between the brood or a super chamber and the roof. The next is a top cover, a type of lid acting as a roof placed over a inner over. So this is the structure of movable frame hive and the part of and their uses or function of movable frame hive. So this is all about the commercial methods of bee rearing. Thank you.